हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल सी द बेजियर कर्व एंड ट्राई टू स्टडी द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ बेजियर कर्व। सो द स्प्लाइंस अप्रोक्सीमेशन मेथड, ओके, इट वाज डेवलप्ड बाय फ्रेंच इंजीनियर पियर बेजियर फॉर यूज इन द डिजाइन ऑफ रेनो ऑटोमोबाइल बॉडीज। सो it was developed specifically to design the automobile bodies, okay, in the Renault company. Okay. Bezier splines have a number of properties that make them highly useful and convenient for curve and surface design. They are also easy to implement. The basic theory over here is, since this was made with an intention to apply it on an automobile body, okay, we'll see some striking differences between the cubic splines or parametric cubic curves and Bezier curves. Okay, this is a approximation curve as we have studied during cubic splines or parametric cubic curves, that there are interpolation curves and there are approximation curves. So cubic spline is interpolation curve, where we have a limitation that every control point, okay, will be on the curve. Okay, every control point will be on the curve, or in other words, curve will pass through every control point. Okay, in the approximation term, okay, there is no such necessity required. Okay, curve cannot pass through each and every control point. Okay, but the control point is going to pull the curve towards itself as far as it can. Okay, that is the approximation present in the drawing of curve. Okay, so Bezier curve is a type of approximation curve. It has got its name because of that French engineer Pierre Bezier, okay, who actually invented this. And the key features of it is easy to implement. Okay, so we'll see how it is being made and what are the properties. So for these reasons, Bezier splines are widely available in various CAD systems. In general, graphics packages such as GLON silicon graphics system, and in assorted drawing and painting packages such as Aldus Superpaint and Cricut Draw. So it is easy to implement, and various softwares have adopted these and given these curves as one of the options to generate Bezier curves, okay, on their software tools, and by that also these curves have become widely famous. In general, a Bezier curve section can be fitted to any number of control points. So contrary to the parametric cubic curve, which was having only 4 control points, okay, Bezier curve can have n control points, okay, and when it has n control points, it will have n degree as well. Okay, so it's an n degree curve with optimum amount of control provided to the provided, wherein we can tune the shape as we want, okay, and still control the degree, and comparatively it will also involve less calculation. Okay, less calculation. So that is the key feature of Bezier curve. The number of control points to be approximated and their relative position determine the degree of the Bezier polynomial. Okay, so this aspect is same, and these are one of the examples of Bezier curve. Okay, now depending on how many control points we have, okay, the degree of the Bezier curve will be decided. So if I have 3 control points, as you can see in this first example, okay, that is P0, P1, P2. I have only 3 control points. Okay, so degree of my Bezier curve is 2. The degree of my Bezier curve is 2. Okay, when I have 3 control points, it is 2. When I have 4 control points, when I add one more control point, okay, the degree of my Bezier curve becomes 3. Okay, so then it is called as cubic Bezier curve. It is called as quadratic Bezier curve. Okay, suppose we have given n plus 1 control point positions. Let's say pk given by xk, yk, zk with k varying from 0 to n. Okay, with k varying from 0 to n. These coordinate points can be blended to produce the following position vector p of u, which describes the path of an approximating Bezier polynomial function between p0 and pn. Okay, so we write a polynomial function for Bezier curve in this regard, that is p of u is summation k equal to 0 to n. So I have, let's say, n control points starting from the first control point being given as number 0. Okay, so p of k is the position defining variable, okay, multiplied by the Bezier function of k comma n of u, okay, of k comma n of u, where the Bezier blending function, that is BEZ subscript k comma n of u, are the Bernstein polynomials. Okay, these are also called as Bernstein polynomials, and they are derived in this manner. So you have BEZ subscript k comma n of u given by c of n comma k multiplied by u raised to k multiplied by 1 minus u raised to n minus k. Okay, multiplied by 1 minus u raised to n minus k, where c, n comma k are binomial coefficients. Okay, are binomial coefficients. So c of n comma k are derived in this manner, n factorial upon k factorial multiplied by n minus k factorial. So it's a binomial coefficient, it's a binomial function. Okay, and this eventually gets multiplied with u raised to k multiplied by 1 minus u raised to n minus k. Okay, so when you actually solve this function, okay, depending on number of control points, okay, the order or the degree of the curve gets defined. Okay, if it's a cubic Bezier, okay, accordingly there will be four terms in these Bernstein polynomials. Okay, there will be four terms in these Bernstein polynomials, and those basically represent the blending functions. Okay, blending functions of the Bezier curve. Blending functions are the properties which tells how the curve is going to behave. Okay, how the curve is going to behave when it travels from starting control point towards the ending control point, and the blending function gives the shape to the curve. Okay, blending function gives the shape to the curve. So equivalently, we can define Bezier blending functions with the recursive calculation. So we can have a recursive calculation in this manner. So BZ subscript k comma n of u, I can rewrite it as 1 minus u multiplied by BZ k comma n minus 1 of u plus u multiplied by BZ k minus 1 comma n minus 1 of u, and so on till I have a condition like n greater than k greater than or equal to 1. So in earlier condition also, it is included into a parametric curve chapter, because it varies according to parameter. So u is always going to be the parameter, and we will always have value of u varying between 0 and 1. So in the previous, as you can see over here, u, which is a parameter that varies between 0 to 1. This condition is also common from parametric cubic curve condition. Okay, with BZ k comma k here becomes u raised to k, and BZ 0 comma k becomes 1 minus u raised to k. Okay, vector equation. Okay, if I have to write a vector equation of these, okay, which represents a set of three parametric equations for the individual curve coordinates. So as we said, p of k, which we will write as which we said over here, okay, p of k as x of k, y of k, z of k. Okay, and then from there we will write a position vector p of u. So that position vector p of u can be generated with the help of x of u, y of u, and z of u. So these are the vector equations, okay, individual curve coordinates. Okay, so it is given by k equal to 0 to n, x of k multiplied by this blending function. Okay, so it is y of u is summation k of 0 to n, y of k multiplied by blending function, and z of u is given by summation k of 0 to n, z of k multiplied by blending function. Okay, a very useful property of a Bezier curve is that it always passes through the first and last control point. So during the discussion of interpolation curves and approximation curves, okay, even though they said the approximation curve is a curve which doesn't pass through any control point, but some additional features Bezier curve is carrying, okay, which you can say are combined features of interpolation as well as approximation curve. So Bezier curve passes through first control point and last control point, okay, and it doesn't pass through intermediate control points. So that is the useful property of Bezier curve that it is having. That is, the boundary condition at the two end points of the curve are, say when it passes through the starting and ending control point, we can define boundary condition, and that is the reason why such property has been awarded to the Bezier curves, and that simplifies calculation to some extent. So I have P at x equal to 0 equal is P0, okay, and P of u P of 0 is equal to P0 and P of 1 is equal to P of n. So this P of 0 is basically, if I am calling it as P of u, okay, P of u, so it is basically the boundary condition wherein P at u equal to 0 is P0 and P at u equal to 1 is Pn. Okay, so that tells us that the parameter is varying between 0 to 1. Okay, so this is the endpoint boundary conditions. Okay, endpoint boundary conditions. Another important property of any Bezier curve is that it lies within the convex hull. Okay, so that is also a good property to have. Okay, the convex hull that we are going to draw, convex polygon boundary. Okay, the Bezier curve will fit itself inside the convex hull of the control points, and this follows from the properties of Bezier blending functions. They are all positive and their sum is always 1. So blending functions, as they provide the shape feature to curve, okay, they are all positive and their sum is always 1. So this is the blending function that I am talking about. So it is summation k equal to 0 to n bez k of k comma n of u equal to 1. So if I take summations, okay, it is all going to be 1. Okay, I can draw and I can enclose this as well. So this p1 to p4 is also going to be a straight line. I can write the control point number starting from p1 ending at p4, or I can write the control point starting from p0 ending at p3. Okay, both have the same meaning. Both have the same meaning. Many graphics packages provide only cubic spline functions. This gives reasonable design flexibility while avoiding the increased calculations needed with higher order polynomials. Cubic Bezier curves are generated with four control points. Now, as we saw the example of quadratic Bezier curve and cubic Bezier curve, okay, so mostly cubic Bezier curves are used in designing, okay, various things, and graphics packages also provide cubic Bezier curve functionality, okay, which is comparatively easy to apply, okay, in their software, and it is a very fast method to generate the curve from four control points. So if I have four control points, my blending functions will look like BEZ. Remember, it is k comma n of u. So if k is going to be 0, 1, 2, 3, okay, 0, 1, 2, 3, that k is just a counter. Okay, k is just a counter variable, so its value is going to start from 0 and going to reach till the number of control points. Okay, till reach till the number of control points. So for k equal to 0, it is the first blending function, that is 1 minus u the whole cube. Okay, when k is equal to 1, it is the second blending function, that is 3u multiplied by 1 minus u the whole square. When k is equal to 2, it is the third blending function, that is 3u square multiplied by 1 minus u. And when k equal to 3, it is the fourth blending function, that is u cube. Now everywhere you can see here the highest power of u is 3. Okay, in the second, again highest power of u is 3. Here also highest power of u is 3. Here also is u cube. So blending functions tells us that it's a cubic behavior of the blending function, and whatever curvature that it is going to generate, okay, I can plot these blending functions. I can plot these blending functions on a graph, and all those curves are cubic curves. Okay, all those curves which we will generate are cubic curves. So at the end positions of the cubic Bezier curve, the parametric first derivative, that is slopes. So I can find out p dash of 0 and p dash of 1. Okay, so p dash of 0 is given by 3 into p1 minus p0, and p dash of 1 is given by 3 into p3 minus p2. 3 into p3 minus p2. And the parametric second derivatives are given by p double dash of 0 equal to 6 of p0 minus 2p1 plus 2p2. And p double dash of 1 is equal to 6 into the bracket p1 minus 2p2 plus p3. So we can use these expressions for the parametric derivatives to construct the piecewise blending functions. Okay, and these are what the blending functions looks like. Okay, so blending function for k equal to 0, that is the first blending function, which is given by this 1 minus u the whole cube. Okay, so when u value is 0, okay, when u value is 0, the y component will be 1, okay, and when u value is 1, okay, the y component is going to be 0. So it has a cubic nature starting from a y component 1 to x component 1. Okay, when u is 1, okay, when u is 1 initially, okay, so then it becomes 0 at first end, okay, and then it becomes 0, okay, so then the x component becomes 1. So it is traveling from 1 to 0, okay, this is also traveling u from 1 to 0, and this is again traveling from 0 to 1, okay, 0 to 1. So that is how we try to identify. So here also, if I put u equal to 0, okay, u equal to 0, what will happen? I will get 0, okay, because u is in multiplication, so eventually I get 0. And when I put over here u is equal to 1, okay, so this 1 minus 1 gives me 0, okay, 1 minus 1 gives me 0 multiplied by this, so eventually again the y component becomes 0, the x component is already u, okay, x component is already 1. In the second, when I put u equal to 0 initially, okay, I get corresponding y component as 0, okay, and when it reaches u equal to 1, it has a cubic behavior. And in the last equation, when I put u equal to 0, it is y component is 0, and when I put u equal to 1, its y component becomes 1. Okay, so that is how all these four blending functions are varying corresponding to their u value and the function value which we are plotting on the y-axis. Okay, the function value which we are plotting on the y-axis against the u-axis, that is the x-axis. This is the y-axis, which is the function value itself. Okay, so that is how the blending function is generated. Okay, then by expanding the polynomial expressions for the blending functions, we can write the cubic Bezier point function in the matrix form. Okay, so I can write the entire thing in a matrix form, stating as P of u equal to a row matrix of u cube, u square, u1 multiplied by the blending function coefficient matrix, that is M BEZ, multiplied by P0, P1, P2, P3. Okay, if I try to find out the matrix M, that is the coefficient matrix of the blending functions, eventually it's a 4 by 4 matrix, which I get as minus 1, 3, minus 3, 1, 3, minus 6, 3, 0, minus 3, 3, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. Okay, so after this, we will see a program, okay, program on how to construct a cubic Bezier curve on a graphical output screen of C program. Okay, and we will try to understand how the program is written. Okay, how the program is written. So now we will see the program that has been written for the Bezier curve. So usual, I have include statements for the inclusion of the library function. So that is standard input output dot h, stdio dot h, then conio dot h, then I am including the graphics dot h header file, then I am including also math dot h, and I am including stdlib dot h, so standard library dot h. Then I am writing a void Bezier function, okay, which has two arguments, int x of 4, so it is a one dimensional array, comma int y 4, this is also one dimensional array. Then inside the function I am writing int gd equal to detect comma gm comma I, okay, so these two are my graphic variables, okay, graphics driver, graphics mode, and I am inputting the I variable for the counter purpose. So I is similar to K, what we have seen in the PPT. Then I am inputting the parametric variable, that is U, okay, with a double data type, so double U. Then initializing the graphics driver, that is init graph, ampersand GD, ampersand GM, comma, the path of my graphics package, okay, that is C colon slash slash turbo C3 slash slash BGI. Okay, then I am writing a loop. See, this Bezier curve, it only depends on the blending function that we have seen. Okay, so it starts with 1 minus u the whole cube, okay, multiplied by the x coordinate, okay, plus 3 times u times 1 minus u the whole square, plus 3 times u square multiplied by 1 minus u, okay, and then it is basically u cube, okay, u cube. So how 1 minus u cube, 1 minus u the whole cube, then 1 minus 3 into u, then 3 u square, and then u cube, okay. So how the coefficients of these functions are arriving, so these are arriving from that Bernstein polynomials, okay, Bernstein polynomials, wherein those are nothing but binomial functions, okay, binomial function. So we solve that binomial function, which is n factorial upon k factorial multiplied by n minus k factorial, and we get the coefficient of all these. So in first term the coefficient is 1, in first term the coefficient is 1, because in first term I have u equal to 0, u equal to 0, k equal to 0, my n remains to be 3, okay, because it is traveling from, or if my n is the number of control points, okay, so 0 if I am starting with, so it is having the value 3, okay, so 3 factorial divided by 0 factorial multiplied by 3 minus 0 factorial, that is again 3 factorial. So 3 factorial divided by 3 factorial, that is 1. So that is why here I have coefficient 1. Okay, and then in a similar way, I get coefficient as 3. Okay, 3 u. Then I here get coefficient as 3 u square. And then eventually I get as u cube. Okay, so that is what is being decided by the Bernstein polynomial, and what we are calling it as the binomial function. Okay, so same we do for y as well. So it is double xu. Okay, this POW is a power function. So whatever we write, it accepts two arguments, is able to run because I have inputted stdlib.h. Okay, so standard library function, and also I have included math.h. So POW is 1 minus u is the first argument, comma is 3 is the second argument. So what it will do, it will give a power to this 1 minus u, so 1 minus u the bracket q, okay, multiplied by the first value, that is x of 0, okay, plus 3 into u into power of 1 minus u comma 2, so 1 minus u the whole square, okay, multiplied by the the second point, that is x of 1. Okay. Now, what are these x of 0s and x of 1s? See, we are going to enter the coordinates of the control points. So these are the x coordinates of control points. So x of 0 is the first coordinate of the control point. X of 1 is the second x coordinate of the control point. Then I have in continuation plus 3 into power of u comma 2, that is 3 into u square into 1 minus u into x of 2. So this is the third coordinate of control point, x coordinate of control point, and plus power of u comma 3, that is u cube multiplied by x of 3. So this is the fourth x coordinate of control point. And similarly, we have the double yu variable calculation as well, exactly similar. Wherever I have written x, I am changing it to y. Okay, rest everything exactly remains the same. Okay, rest everything exactly remains the same. If we have z coordinate, then we are trying to draw the three dimensional curve. Okay, then also we will have a third row representing double of zu, and we will write the same thing, same function. Wherever I have y, I will replace it by z. Okay, and then what I am going to do, I am going to plot this each pixel position which is being given to us by x, u, y, u. Now I have put this entirely into a for loop which is varying between the parameter, which is varying between the parameter. So here the parameter value is starting from 0.0. Now we have taken it double. Remember, the parameter varies between 0 and 1. Okay, so I cannot take it as integer. Okay, I have to take it as float, or I have added accuracy. So that's why I have taken it as double. So starts from 0.0, okay, it goes till 1, okay, so u less than 1.0. and what is the increment in u? The increment in u is being incremented by 0.0005. okay, u is being incremented by 0.0005. okay, you can reduce this number and you will get more points, so that the curve will be displayed more smoothly on graphical output device. So then inside this, I am calculating this xu, yu, and for each xu, yu, I am going to print that pixel onto the graphic screen. So put pixel xu, yu, blue is the color with which that pixel will be highlighted. Okay, so this is going to plot all the points. Okay, this is going to plot all the points. Now, to plot control points. Okay, now to plot control points, I have another for loop. So for I equal to 0, I less than 4, I plus plus. How many times this for loop will run? This will run 3 times. Okay, so 0, 1, 2, 3, and then the next time I will become 4, and this for loop will be terminated. And it has only single line, so I don't have to give bracket. Okay, so put pixel x of I, comma y of I, comma yellow. So it is going to print 4 control points for me. Then I have getch for the input output screen connections, and then I am closing the graph function to release the graphical memory, and I have written over here the return statement so that it will go back to the main function. Okay, it will go back to the main function. Then I have void main, which is very very simple. So I am inputting the two array variables, x of 4, y of 4, and a counter variable I. Okay, I am asking user to enter x and y coordinates of 4 control points. So user has to enter the coordinates in terms of x, y, x, y, x, y, x, y for 4 control points. And I am saving those into these array variables using a scanf statement and for loop. So for I equal to 0, I less than 4, I plus plus, scanf percent percent, because there are two values. Those are stored inside ampersand xi, ampersand yi. So the values are getting stored inside xi and yi. And I'm calling the Bezier function. So this is my function call. Okay, this is my function call. So then the program will directly jump here, follow all the instructions, and again come back to the main with the help of return function, and that's it. So I'll just check the program for errors. So there are no errors. So I'll execute the program. So now I have to enter 4 control points. Remember, these control points are going to define the shape. So I'll start with, let's say, first control point is 100 comma 100. The second control point is 300 comma 150. Okay. Third control point as, let's say, 300 comma 350. And fourth control point, I will again go back to my x coordinate as 100. And I will write here y coordinate is 150. So when I do that, this is the shape that gets displayed. So as you can see over here, the control points are displayed with yellow color and the Bezier curve is getting displayed with the blue color. Now the control points are trying to pull the curve towards itself. Okay, and the property of Bezier curve states that it is going to pass through the first control point and the last control point, and the intermediate control points it is not going to be passing through. So if I change the coordinates, so let us change the coordinates and let us have some let's say 100 300 100 then 300 and 350 and then again 100 and 300 300 okay, so now you can see 100 100 100 300, okay, then 300 350 is slightly down and 100 and 300. Okay, so the points are not, first two points are on horizontal line, the second two points are on vertical line. The first and last point is also on a vertical line, but the second last and last point is not on horizontal line. So the shape is what we are interested in. So control point location controls the shape of the Bezier curve. That property is being showcased over here. And if we change the position of control point by keeping, let's say, first and last control point same, and if we change the position of intermediate control points, okay, the shape of the curve gets changed. So that is what I just wanted to showcase. So I hope you have understood the program. The program is fairly simple. Okay, the shortest program as far as the graphical programs that we have written so far. Okay, but yet it generates a very complex kind of a curve, and when we change the control point locations, the curve shape also drastically changes. Okay, so I hope you have understood the program as well as the properties of Bezier curve and its importance. So hope to see you next time with more such graphical content and computer aided design content. So thank you very much.